To prove this, the move to epsilon delta definition, you always want to say given epsilon is greater than 0 and then say choose delta is equal to blank, and you say suppose the absolute value of this minus that is in between of 0 and delta, and you say check the absolute value of the function minus the limit, and you see this right here, we can factor, we can break it apart. Notice that the absolute value of x minus 3 is less than delta, which is very nice. And now, when we are dealing with a quadratic situation, just go ahead and do the following. You take the delta to be the minimum, and you always use 1 because it's easy. So you put down the 1 right here, and when you have 1, you can look at this inequality, and you change that to be the absolute value of x minus 3 is less than 1. But you see this right here, we want to end up with the absolute value of x plus 3, right? So just go ahead and add 6 on both sides. Don't worry, this is okay. And you get the absolute value of x plus 3 is less than 7. So this right here, we'll just replace that with 7. Well, you see, in the end, we want to end up with epsilon. So you see, delta shall be epsilon over 7, so that the 7 will cancel out, and you just put this down right here, epsilon over 7, and you make this less than or equal to, and then in the end, you are done!